Hey guys, this is Martin from SIRS Electronics. Today I wanted to talk to you about compensating for brightness loss as it goes down the strip. This particular technique is useful mostly when you're using the MX, but you could kind of mimic the same effect with RF controllers and other things like that. But today we're going to talk about the LED-CON2-R2 or the LED-CON2 to do this. So basically, I got here 10 meters of dual density RGB strip. Typically, this strip is only advised to run in 5-meter segments and, you know, amplified in between. But we're going to show you how you could actually make it run up to 10 meters, or probably a little bit more, without any issues if you follow this technique. So basically, I got a power supply and my first LED-CON2. And right now, this is the end of the strip, and it's not connected at all to anything. So if I turn up the brightness on the channels, you'll see that there's a color variation here because of the voltage drop, and that's happening because the colors lost the correct mix. So at the beginning of the strip, you know, it looks white, it looks really even, it looks nice, but as it gets to the end, it starts to get really, really weird. So, you know, if you were to do this in a real life installation, you would definitely see this discoloration on the strip, and then you could tell color by color that the colors aren't as bright as they should be. And we got green, and you could probably tell on the blue the most. And that's the issue you're having there. So let's go back to white. And then the way this works is basically to bring your brightness back up, you need another LED-CON2-R2 that's hooked up to the same power supply or separate power supply, whichever works best for you. So these two are hooked up. Right now I'm using just Cat5 cable, but you could use DMX cable to daisy chain them, or, you know, but they're basically daisy chained. And then what you do at the end of the strip, you're going to add another lead going into the same strip. And these two LED-CON2-R2s, they must be in the same address, because if they're not in the same address, you're going to throw off the whole thing and you're not going to get what you're trying to do. So right now I'm using a clip-on connector. Usually these work okay, but it's best to always solder all your leads. But right now, just for the sake of showing you guys, I'm going to do it like this. So basically, I'm just going to put it in here. See if we could get it. And right there, you could see that the brightness level went back up, and it's almost the same or the same as the beginning of the strip. So if you see that again, if I pull it off, you could see how the brightness comes down. There's a big change. And if you put it back on, you could see it come back up. Of course, if this is installed better with solders, and instead of using this clip-on connector, you'll get a more strong hold and everything. And, you know, you could probably see them better right there. There's also going to be a close-up of this. But basically, that's pretty much how you do it. So remember, I'm going to show you guys a diagram where the whole connection is shown on paper, so you guys could visualize it a little bit better. But basically, all you need is two LED-CON2s per segment, and, you know, you power it from both ends, and that's pretty much how you do it. Just make sure they're on the same DMX address. So this is pretty much what I wanted to show you guys. So I really hope this is helpful for you, and I hope you enjoy the video. So if you guys have any questions or comments, don't forget to drop them there, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.